Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for winter 2019. The drier and warmer than average conditions that we saw in autumn are likely to continue into winter for southern Australia. But with more clear nights, we'll see an increased risk of frost. First, let's look at recent conditions. After a dry start to autumn, a few areas had good rainfall in May, thanks to two tropical cyclones and well-timed cold fronts further south. But other parts saw little rain at all. Southwestern areas of Western Australia have been exceptionally dry. Geraldton, at the top of the WA grain belt, has had only 1 millimetre of rainfall in May, its driest May on record, and less than 6 millimetres for the year to date. Temperatures continued warmer than average in May, with hot days for this time of year in the northwest of Western Australia. Broome had 17 days above 35 degrees in May, a new record for the site. Australia-wide, it's been the warmest start to the year on record. With warm and dry conditions, soil moisture remains below average in many key agricultural regions of southern Australia. The unusual dryness was highlighted by several exceptionally late dust storms. Water storage levels in southern Australia usually stop falling by the end of May. However, most storage levels in the southeastern mainland are still going down. And total storage levels in the northern Murray-Darling Basin are now at just 7%. So what's driving our climate right now? Ocean temperatures in the tropical Pacific are near El Niño thresholds, but these waters are forecast to cool over the coming months. So our ENSO outlook has now dropped back to El Niño watch. Over the Indian Ocean, waters off Indonesia are also forecast to cool. That tells us that a positive Indian Ocean Dipole, or IOD, is likely to form during winter. Historically, when we've seen a positive IOD, we've seen less winter-spring rainfall across central and southern Australia. Whether or not El Niño or a positive IOD forms, higher pressures are forecast over southern Australia this winter. That means clearer skies and weather systems and rainfall push to the south of the continent. So what's our outlook for winter? Below average rainfall is likely for much of eastern Australia, as well as for southern coastal Western Australia. Turning to stream flows from May to July, low flows are likely for nearly two-thirds of locations across Australia. Near median and high flows are likely along the eastern seaboard, particularly in Queensland. In terms of temperatures, days are likely to be warmer than average for most of Australia. Clear nights and dry soils in the south will raise the risk of frost inland. So in summary, a drier than average winter is likely, particularly in the east. Temperatures are likely to be warmer than average for winter. Low stream flows are likely at most locations, and there's a higher risk of frost for inland parts of southern Australia. For more details, visit bom.gov.au/climate/ahead. Our first look at likely conditions for July to September will be available on Thursday, the 13th of June. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.